And now let's get Guile and install this one. Okay, we've already got it. Oh, this was for... It needs GDB, but we've already installed it, haven't we? Let's, just get my spreadsheet back up. And just check what we've got in here. Right, yeah, it's not God I need to do. That's what I needed to redo that. It was just GCC, yeah. So, I need to really deal with Doxygen. I wonder why that's not working, because the rebuild I got is to rebuild GDB after Doxygen and GCC have been built, but Doxygen, I still can't get it installing with the documentation for CLang for some reason. I'm not sure what's happening there. User switch VLVM with CLang uninstalled. Total support for... Oh, no, it's not documentation for lib CLang passing. Require formulas to create PDF documentation, you must have text live. So it doesn't seem to be anything to do with what I thought would be the text live, this switch here. It's a bit strange why that's not working. So might Doxygen GDB, let's just have this GDB. Right, I haven't got actually got anything to do with LVM directly, so I might just reinstall this now. And that'll be another one off the rebuild list. Yeah, let's do this one now. So let's create the build first, build directory, and then copy the configure. Let's check what commands we called. System readline is there. Python, there's nothing else. Okay. So we can just put that in and build it. So let's now install the package. The number of tests is just a little bit over what was expected, but there's so many dependencies on it. There's no specifics as there is in the main GCC compilation pages of the LFS book, so we'll just carry on. It's not widely out. So let's install the documentation as well. And that's all complete. So that's GDB reinstalled. I'm going to mark that one as complete now in my list. And then we can move on to the next one. Yeah, that Doxygen, I was thinking about that again while this GDB was compiling. There's a chance that, as we've already seen, there's a chance that the switches, the extra config switches, are not appropriate for the current version. We've seen that happen already. Where it appears that some dependencies doesn't quite tie up what we're being told, what we're seeing, and so on in the book. So I'm going to leave Doxygen and assume that's been installed correctly now, without the extra switch for CMake. Obviously, if there seems to be a problem with that, we can try and reinstall Doxygen again. So bearing that in mind, I was going to do GraphFizz next, but I think what I shall do is I'm going to go through my list of rebuilds and rebuild the packages that are just waiting for Doxygen for the rebuild. That's the reason why they're in the rebuild list, just for Doxygen. So I think that's probably the best thing to do. At least it gets rid of a few of this rebuild list, because, I mean, ultimately, this is what it's all about now. It's we've got this is a position where we've got Doxygen built. I'm going to take that tab off, actually, as well. And GDB's done as well.